Hello students, today we are going to discuss epithelial tissue. It is a type of animal tissue. In animal, the tissue which acts as the protective tissue is epithelial tissue. It is simplest type of the animal tissue, acts as a protective covering in the animal. It may have one layer or more than one layer of cells which are tightly cohesive sheets of the cell, which acts as tightly cohesive sheets attached with one sheet to other, like this one sheet of cell attached with the other sheet of cell, then third, then fourth. It may be in one or two or more than two layers. These tissue mainly cover the external surface of the body and visceral organs, or lining of the internal cavities and visceral organs, like skin, mouth, alimentary canal layer, lungs. These all are made up of epithelial tissue. In this epithelial tissue, cells are the closely packed, one cell attached with other cell, like the tiles of a floor, and no intercellular space is present. The cells are together held by intercellular junctions with the help of cementing material. And below the epithelial tissue, or you can say epithelial tissue, rests on a membrane, thin cement, non-cementing material, and this membrane, non-cellular membrane, and this membrane is known as a basement membrane. The epithelium is not traversed by the blood vessels, but the blood vessels lie in connective tissue across the basement membrane. Basement membrane have connective tissue and in which blood vessels are present. Now, the general function of epithelial tissue, it mainly provide protection to the parts of the body. It help in absorption of the water and digested food. It help in secretion or elimination of the nitrogenous waste material. And it also acts as a goblet cell or glands to secrete the hormones or enzymes in the body. Now, the types of epithelial tissue on the basis of their cell shape. These epithelial tissue are mainly two types, simple and compound epithelial tissue. But on the basis of shape, in your class, mainly there are mainly four or five type of tissue: squamous epithelial tissue, cuboidal, columnar, ciliated, and glandular epithelial tissue. Now, these may be simple and compound. Simple, compound, simple columnar, compound, complex columnar, simple ciliated, complex ciliated. These may be further different types, but main types are these. First of all, we are going to discuss about squamous epithelial tissue. As the diagram indicated, in the squamous epithelial tissue, in this tissue, thin, flat, and irregular cell shape are fit together each other like the tiles closely packed in the floor. They are commonly known as pavement epithelium. This squamous epithelial tissue also known as pavement epithelium tissue. And this diagram indicates the vertical section of the squamous epithelial tissue, and this diagram indicates the surface view of the epithelial tissue. Now, the squamous epithelial tissue is of two types: simple squamous epithelial tissue or stratified or multi-layered. Simple and stratified or multi-layered epithelial tissue. The simple squamous epithelial tissue have a single layer of cells which are closely packed, and it mainly covers the lines of the blood vessel, ciliary, urinary tubules, and alveoli of the lungs. This tissue is mainly present in that organs where absorption and secretion occur. And the stratified or multi-layered epithelium tissue have many layers of the cell, attached with each other. Many layers of the cell. Like this, many layers of the cell. One layer of the cell, then a second layer of the cell, then third layer of the cell, then fourth layer of the cell. These are present in many layers. This slide. And it indicates the multi-layered or stratified epithelium tissue. And stratified epithelium tissue is mainly present in skin. This epithelial tissue is mainly present in skin because it have many layered, so it provide wear and tear resistant to the skin. It prevent the skin from wearing and tearing. So this type epithelial tissue is also known as stratified, or strata means you can say many layers epithelium tissue. Now the functions of the squamous epithelial tissue. It help in absorption, secretion and exchange of the siloamic fluid, gaseous exchange. It also provide the skin and body from mechanical injury and also prevent the entry of the germs in the body. In this video, we discuss the one type of epithelial tissue, that is squamous epithelial tissue, where it may be present, what type of the squamous epithelial tissue and what are the function of the squamous epithelial tissue. In next video, we are going to discuss cuboidal epithelial tissue. Till then, take care everyone. Bye.